Let us study indices and their properties. First of all, why do we need indices? Let us start with an example. Suppose we have three apples. Now, consider three times of three apples. Now, three times of these apples. Again, three times of these and so on. Can you tell that how many apples do we have at each stage? Initially, we have 3 apples. Then, 3 times of 3, that is 9 apples. After that, 3 times of 9, that is 27, then 81, then 243 and so on. Observe that, instead of considering the apples actually, it is simpler to write using multiplication. Like 3 into 3, for 9, 3 into 3 into 3 for 27, 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 for 81, 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, that is 3 multiplied with itself 5 times for 243 and so on. But again, it is tedious to write a number using multiplication like 3 into 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 3, where 3 is multiplied with itself 10 times. Can we think of something simpler? Since we are multiplying just 3 with itself 10 times, it is better to remember the number 3 and the number of times we are multiplying it. That is 10 in this case. Thinking in similar fashion, instead of 3 into 3 into 3 into 3, we can simply remember the number 3 and the number of times to multiply it, which is 4. We represent it like 3 raised to 4. We call 3 as base and 4 as index or power or exponent. Hence, 3 multiplied with itself 6 times, that is 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 can be written as 3 raised to 6. Similarly, 2 raised to 5 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, which is multiplication of 2 with itself 5 times. Note that it is more convenient to write 2 raised to 5 than in terms of multiplication. Similarly, for any non-zero number a, by a square we mean a into a, and by a cube we mean a into a into a. In general, for a natural number n, we have a raised to n is equal to a into a into a n times, that is multiplication of a with itself n times. Let us consider few examples to understand the difference between multiplication and exponentiation. When we write 3 into 2, it means 3 plus 3, that is having 3 objects and 3 more objects, which is equal to 6. When we write 3 square, it means 3 into 3, that is having 3 times 3 objects, which is equal to 9. Similarly, 2 into 3 means 2 plus 2 plus 2, that is addition of 2 taken thrice, which is equal to 6. But 2 cube means 2 into 2 into 2, that is multiplication of 2 taken thrice, which is equal to 8. Observe that we have 3 into 2 is equal to 2 into 3, as both are equal to 6, but 3 square and 2 cube are not equal. Now, let us consider an interesting puzzle. Just imagine you find Aladdin's magic lamp. You rub the lamp and the genie appears. The genie wants to reward you. He makes an offer. You can have 10 lakhs of gold coins, or you can have a magical gold coin. The magical gold coin will turn into 2 coins on the first day. On the second day, the 2 gold coins will turn into 4. On the third day, 4 coins will double and become 8. This will go on for a month. Which offer will you choose? Do you think 10 lakhs of gold coins? Okay, let us see what the other offer is. On the first day, you have 2 coins. On the second day, 2 into 2, that is 4 coins. On third day, 4 into 2, that is 8, or 2 into 2 into 2, or 2 raised to 3 coins. On fourth day, 8 into 2, that is 16, or 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, that is 2 raised to 4 coins. And so on, continuing till end of the month. Can you imagine how many coins do we have at the end of 30 days? Observing the pattern, we see that it will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 30 times, that is 2 raised to 30, which is equal to 10737418244 coins. Too huge as compared with 10 lakhs of coins. This is why fast growth is called as exponential growth. We have seen basics of indices. Will you now like to solve few problems? What do you think? Are minus 3 raised to 2 and minus of 3 raised to 2 equal? Or what about the equality of minus 3 raised to 3 and minus of 3 raised to 3? Can you tell, is minus 3 raised to 25 equal to minus of 3 raised to 25? Can you justify? Another problem, for non-zero numbers a and b, can a plus b the whole square and a square plus b square be equal? You can begin by using particular values for a and b. Generalizing, we can ask for the equality of a plus b whole raised to n and a raised to n plus b raised to n, where n is a natural number.